Brighton is famous for its graffiti. It coats walls in the city centre, stretches out to Whitehawk and Worthing, and can often have a polarising effect on people. Art and Believe are a graffiti group whose engaging work reaches rooftops and walls across the world, and I met them as they finished up a piece in Whitehawk.
I think it's been particularly good in this area. I think people have really interacted, really, you know, appreciated us coming here and actually making something on in this area. But obviously, it was a rundown building, and for us it's just doing something that is making improvements and to a particular space. That's what we enjoy doing, really.
They work with a company called Baobab, who connect artists with their development projects.
I think they're being conscious that to give something back to the community that they work in, to also think about helping artists in the local area. So we're really grateful for that.
The piece behind them took 2 days to reach this stage, but their work operates across all sorts of scales. The Sky Gallery covers the roof of the Holiday Inn on the seafront and is a colourful spark visible from the I-360.
It's a project that we've had for, like, in our minds for a very long time, since obviously the viewing platform of the I-360 was put onto the seafront. It's taken a long time to get to the point of painting it. Maybe a year of talking and planning and, you know, logistics. And then as far as other things go, it was 400 litres of paint. It was 1 month of painting. Obviously, the three of us were all involved heavily in that, but there was other people who were also involved in the project.
I think the, one of the biggest challenges we found was the weather, because obviously when you're on ground level, it's quite different from being 20 stories up. And the biggest problem, I think, was when it was really windy. It's quite sort of challenging being up there, wasn't it?
Yeah, totally. And the fact that we couldn't see the piece, so we're standing on the piece we're painting, and the only time we could really have a good look at it was when Sam, our drone pilot, got the drone up, and then we could see whether the piece was adhering to the symmetry we wanted in it and actually producing the mural we wanted. But that was about 2 weeks in before we actually saw what we were painting, so that was kind of strange.
Yeah, completely. Yeah. I think it's a new experience to most people, because as you usually make a piece of artwork, you can always stand back. Like we've painted this, and we can always have tabs on how it's moving, because we can go to the other side of the street and have a look and go, right, what's the big picture? How's it looking? How's it work with our design? With the roof, like we said, you couldn't see it from a long time until you actually got a view from above.
They're not done yet. Art and Believe have more city centre projects heading your way.
Yes, we are working with Brighton. Around town. It's the 25, isn't it? The Bender bus.
Yeah. And we also have another really exciting project with the buses, but we can't really talk about that yet.
Their work is all over the world. They've been to India, Indonesia, and across South America, and through that experience, they can offer some insight for artists.
If we were going to give any piece of advice, it's you need to be sort of pragmatic in what you do, so you need to kind of work and keep moving and doing things rather than being precious about what you do. For us, it's been just producing and moving and taking risks, you know, that's how we've got to this point.
They paint walls, they brighten rooftops, their buses will be rolled out soon. Keep your eyes open across the city for Art and Believe. For latest TV news, Matthew Enderby.
Yeah, you'll have to watch his face.